it's your girl, Dr. Nina, and I believe we all know who that girl is. It's been trending all year, but I want us to step it up a notch into becoming that woman. Yes, grown woman style, but to use realistic ways in order for us to start over to become just that. Now, I don't believe that woman is just waking up early every morning with the perfect morning routine, skincare routine, journaling habits are perfect, as well as meditation and workouts. Mm-mm. This woman has self-fulfillment and true life skills that are essential, but also has fallen flat on her face a time or even 10, but uses all of those experiences to push her closer to her goals. Now, I know what it's like to fail at fitness, relationships, networking skills, career aspirations, and even give up on my dreams at times. But I also know what it's like to succeed at getting healthier, start and maintain successful relationships, build a supportive and solid network, grow in my career, and see my dreams through. Now, today's video is meant to inspire and motivate with a lot of those ways that we can take our challenges and move them into goals and actually getting what we want from life. And you know I want to hear from you. Let me know your stories down below, as well as some of your comments and things that are helping you these days. And as always, the items from my Amazon shop will be linked down below for you so that you can have some things that help you on your way. Make sure you join that free text community, which is going to let you know when I have those free masterclasses and other events that I'm a part of. And y'all, just like this video, it's 100% free, but it also keeps me in your algorithm. YouTube has changed some things, I'm telling you, and I want to make sure that you're still getting everything I have to offer over here. Now let's get into this video. With starting over, it's best to accept what it is. One of my favorite quotes is, "A fresh start is not a new place. It's a new mindset." Sometimes it's human nature to not want to face where we are right now and today. But even when you're building a new house, you need to repair the foundation and make sure that you're addressing the cracks in it as well. Now, journaling is one thing, but I find that simply keeping note of what you already love about yourself and see as your strengths is great, but also meeting that with what you see as less favorable about yourself. When you look at yourself like that, you become more realistic, and you're also able to focus on how you feel about yourself today. And when I did that, I was able to face what I needed to work on and look at myself in the mirror. And through looking at what I loved about myself, I was able to practice gratitude. I was also able to find joy in the very small basics, like having food, shelter, warmth, the thing I needed in order for me to move forward to become my best. And this really worked in a major way with my fitness journey, really because I didn't always feel like I liked myself. And when I did this type of exercise, I found that I already did. Why is that important? Because when I was losing over 100 pounds, and if you're holding out on any other thing or telling yourself, "Oh, I'll love myself better when," you stop doing that because you realize that you're worth your self-love. You're worth the love of others at this point in time, no matter if you are a work in progress. So when you're able to look at yourself for who and what you are, you begin to accept it, which actually elevates you. It helps you to accept everything about who you are and what you are, and even look forward to what you're becoming. Self-care has been a major part of starting over for me. I needed real spiritual, mental, physical, and emotional health. I have to feed myself well, rest and exercise, and also get some good balance in my mental health. Yes, I have a morning routine, but it's much more than just waking up and looking cute and getting fresh. Y'all know I love some healthy habits, and one of my newest favorites is Athletic Greens, who's bringing you all today's video. Athletic Greens is a daily supplement that has me excited about simplifying my daily health routine. It has 75 different ingredients, including vitamins, minerals, superfoods, probiotics, and adaptogens. And if that's not self-care, I don't know what it is. And one major goal for me for staying that woman is making sure that I have healthy digestion. But what I love is, since starting it, I feel like I have more optimal absorption and less of those gut issues. I feel like my digestion is better supported. And I don't feel like I need to eat everything in sight because my body is being supported by the absorption of all these great nutrients. I also feel like I have more energy and I'm consuming less coffee during the day. And it's also vegan, paleo, and keto friendly. Amazing. And y'all, it tastes so good. I love having it in the morning, either by itself in water with almond milk or even in my smoothie. So get your greens. Go to athleticgreens.com/Dr. Nina to get started with your order. Athletic Greens is going to give my community a free one-year supply of immune-supporting vitamin D and 5 free travel packs with your first purchase. Also, in terms of self-care, I've learned the value of spending time with myself and on myself. And look, I couldn't get anywhere until I actually showed love to myself. I engage in what makes me happy and what irons out my stress levels. My goal is to be purposeful in my self-maintenance and to not only be purposeful, but to enjoy it. That means doing things like washing my hair and my body with love and care, exercising every day or just some days and telling myself why that's essential, spending time with God and meditating. And the big one, having me time when it's necessary, because that's how I recharge. But this also involves recreation and doing the things that you love. And I love brunches. Yes, I said brunches. And I also love speaking and making videos like I am right now. And I enjoy making people smile and doing things that are worthwhile. Bars. Now, once I was able to sort through my weaknesses and really seek therapy for them, I also enlisted the help of wonderful mentors. And mentorship has taken my life to 100. When I tell y'all, we are all human and we all need help in specific areas, and that's not always available. Mentorship has given me just that. And the great thing about mentors is they can empathize with you, see your life for what it is, and provide guidance according to their own life and professional skills. Now, the great thing too is that most of them are built in. Most of my mentors have been friends, family members, and professionals that have been in my life. And y'all, let me tell you this. I was struggling. It's a transparency moment. I was struggling in the area of growth of romantic relationships, and I really wanted to change that. And so I sought out the help of people who have been married 30, 40 plus years realistically and had the skills available to teach me about what's necessary to prepare yourself for marriage properly. But also I sought the help of those that had gone through divorces, bad breakups, and things like that to talk about things to avoid, pitfalls, and other things to look for in myself in order to make changes. And this led me to looking at the cold, hard truth about myself, my stubbornness, and my ability to drop people like a hot skillet. And once I got some guidance, I was able to make better decisions for myself. I dissected exactly what I wanted from a relationship and started to prepare myself for it. I prayed and I wrote down exactly what I needed from a life partner for them to fit into the core of my life. And most of that list will be revealed when I get married next month. I placed myself in the right positions and opened myself to new modes of dating. And I moved on quickly from those that didn't offer what I was looking for. I was real with myself, and most of all, I did not settle. And I also say in mentoring, find a person that's able to help you dive deep into your purpose. And stay away from the people who are trying to tell you what you should do in life. They should just offer encouragement. This is your life and you gotta live it. And there's always my mentorship membership program linked down below for you. And I have a little 10% off code. To start over in life, it takes courage, curiosity, hope, and embracing change. I had to learn the hard way to move with change. Life changes daily and things change. And one thing that has taught me that has been failures in relationships. When I finally started to really explore outside of my protective bubble, I found that I had these communication skills that I never knew existed because I never had to exercise them when I was trying to protect myself from certain things and certain people. I was playing it safe, and to be honest, I was becoming quite stagnant. And this also led to a shift in a lot of my friendships. And that's why I believe that your network can make or break you. It's so important that you not only have people that you can help, but people who are invested in helping you. I learned that it was okay to ask for help. Also, allow people to know when I needed them and when I felt most comfortable with expressing vulnerability in situations where I just felt like I needed more help, more guidance, and more people to step up in my life. That's okay as well. I've also had to learn the art of how to let go. A lot of us like to say how we're over things, but we really haven't allowed the time or the place for that to happen. There were some negative situations, some bad friendships and relationships, as well as career setbacks that still had a big hold on me. I learned to let go by building and engaging in better habits. I learned to balance my ego by realizing I didn't always have to be right or even perfect. I learned to let down my guard with the right people. I also learned to become more discerning with my decision making and who I would allow in my life and who I needed to let go of in my life. Now, self-awareness has also helped in this area, and being aware of the self means that you're more aware of certain aspects of your traits, behaviors, characteristics, and also your feelings. And through spending time with myself, truly, I learned a lot about my personality. My wit and my charm are on 10, but y'all, seriously, my mouth can get me in trouble and it can also hurt feelings. So just like I have the power to motivate, I also have the power to knock down buildings with my words. So I have to watch how I talk to people. I think carefully before I speak, and I also don't allow my anxiety to completely take over situations. And one way that's out there to learn more about this is Enneagrams. It's a better way to understand yourself just a little bit more and others, and also learn more about what motivates you to do what you do. So for instance, my personality type with an Enneagram is said to be a type 3 achiever. The basic fear for that is being worthless. The basic desire is to feel valuable and worthwhile. It's described as the charmer and also the professional. Now it gets much deeper than that, and there's so much information out there on the net about it, and I'm going to place a link down below just in case you're interested in finding out more and how it might help you to know more and become more self-aware about your type of personality. I think it'll be worth it and it might be fun to find out. Now y'all, starting over and becoming that girl, that woman, wherever you are in your development is essential and important for what we are and what we're becoming. So I want you to feel good about where you are, even if it's not where you want to be, so that you're able to use that feeling to propel you to your next level. Sometimes through the work, you start to really appreciate yourself more. So give yourself a chance. Make sure that you comment, share this video with someone who can use it, and subscribe. Thanks so much for watching, guys. Beautiful brown baby doll. Peace. Check the links in the description for my free new Dr. Nina's Mentorship Facebook group, which is a group of like-minded individuals looking to progress, grow, and support one another along the way. The Now That's Life podcast is about to go into season 2, so I suggest you go ahead and subscribe to the podcast on all your major podcasting platforms. All descriptions and links for that and my free supernatural video course are found below. Thanks so much for all the love and support over on my new website. If you haven't already, go ahead and check it out and join me for new ways to interact with me, giveaways and prizes, weekly emails, as well as my free 8-day supernatural video course, which is free when you sign up.